Bitcoin is considered a cryptocurrency, and if you don't know what cryptography is, cryptography, crypto means secret, and graphy means writing. So cryptography is the science or the study of making something so that the writing is a secret, so that people don't know what it is. So that, okay, so what happens is when this virtual currency or this cryptocurrency or this digital currency or electronic currency, it doesn't matter what you call it, you know, it's all going through the computers and the internet, all right? So don't let none of those labels like cryptocurrency, virtual currency, digital currency, electronic money, don't let any of that confuse you. It just all means that it's going through the internet, okay? Or it's in the form of of electricity, not in the physical form that you normally see as gold or silver or coins or a piece of paper. So what happened was the first challenge for Satoshi to make this, okay, to make this new currency system so that it can benefit the 99% of people like you and I on Main Street. The first thing that the challenge came up to was to make sure that it was safe, okay? So that when you send money to me, okay, let's down here, I'm gonna erase this. Remember, this is called the blockchain, okay? The blockchain is nothing more, just to review, the blockchain is nothing more than a public ledger. It's just a public notebook that indicates all the transactions that's ever been done in the Bitcoin world, okay? So let's say that down here, right? This is you, okay? And this is me over here. Now, some of you guys may not know that I'm a world-class artist here, but there it is, now you know, okay? So let's say that you wanted to send me money, okay? What happens is, if you want to send me, let's just say a dollar, okay? We'll just say one US dollar, it doesn't matter, okay? In this case, it's gonna be a Bitcoin, it's not gonna be a dollar because we're in the Bitcoin system now. So what happens is when you send me the dollar, one of the first things that Satoshi was concerned about was that it actually came from you and it actually goes to me, okay? So by using all this computer science and mathematical science and this cryptography that a lot of the software companies, a lot of the spy agencies like the Central Intelligence Agency, the CIA, the FBI, all these big name people, right, that they use to make sure that when they send you information that it goes directly to you, right? That was one of the keys, right, is authenticity. Meaning that it really did come from you, and it's going to me and not someone else. Authenticity, right? So that's very easy. All the software companies that like Microsoft and places like Adobe, they use this process all the time. Every time they send you a new software update, they make sure that they authenticate it with your computer so that your computer knows that it's coming from Microsoft directly. It's not coming from a scam website, or it's not coming from a bogus, hold on real quick. They authenticate that first, okay? So that part was easy. Now, the part that was very, very difficult to create this new currency system, right, was the double spend. Double spend means that if you send me a dollar, since it's electronic money, what's to prevent you from sending that $1 to someone else? Okay, if you can do that infinitely, then it would just be the same as these people over here randomly just printing money without having to work for it. So that would not work, okay? And so for like 20 or 30 years since cryptography came into existence and into heavy study using computers and stuff, right? A bunch of people have been trying to figure this out. So Satoshi is not the first person to attempt to create a currency that works, okay? However, he was the first person, or she was the first person, right, to come up with a system, and that system is what we call the blockchain or the public ledger. And what Satoshi proposed is that all the transactions that's ever made, okay, remember I told you in the previous video that every block takes 10 minutes to create, okay? So every 10 minutes, the Bitcoin system goes around the world and it tracks all the transactions and it records it, how much everybody spends. Boom, right there, okay? Then the next 10 minutes, another block will come on. Well, what Satoshi did was to prevent this double spending issue, which was a huge issue because lots of math scientists, lots of computer scientists trying to figure out how can we create a currency system where we can send it to another human being without double spending and using it again to send to someone else. So what Satoshi did was, hey, if he said, or she said, hey, what if we create a block here and we make it public that all the transactions have to go here. So what happens is when you send me that $1, it records on here a minus one to show that you have deducted $1 or one Bitcoin from your account. And then over here, it will show in the same ledger, it will show my account and it will show that Ty has received one Bitcoin. So now I have a plus one in my account and you have a minus one in your account. And now in the next blockchain, let's just say that if I want to send that dollar, right? Let's just say that I want to send it to, let's say, I don't know, let's just make up a name. I'm just going to say John, because in America, John Doe is a common name that we use for all examples, all right? So, what happens is, if I send this $1 over here, the first thing that the Bitcoin system is going to do to make sure that I have that dollar is it's going to go back to the previous blockchain and check inside that blockchain to see if I in fact have a dollar to send to someone else. So it's going to go back here and it's going to check and it's going to go, oh, there it is. There goes that transaction where Ty received a $1 from you. And what's going to happen is it's going to authenticate that and say, oh, okay, so Ty does have a dollar and then now I am authorized to send that dollar to John. Okay, now keep in mind that in the old banking system, or what you know they commonly call the legacy banking system. Legacy just means that the old system. So in this fiat legacy 1%, you know, benefit only the 1% on Wall Street banking system here. Remember that they don't have to go back and check to see if they got the money or not. If they don't have it, they just print a bunch of numbers in the computer. It's not like they have to print out a piece of paper or anything. It's just they just go into the computer and just boom, 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 put in their password, and boom, this bank sends them more money, and now they got more money in their bank, okay? So this is what they call in America the good old boy system, okay? Now, over here, it's not a good old boy system. It's based on proof, okay? It's very important. It's based on proof that you actually have that money to spend or to send to someone else. So now when I send it to John, it gets recorded in the next current block of information. Remember, this is called a blockchain, okay? Because it's a chain of blocks, and each block contains all the transactions in the world that happened up to that point, okay? So this block just keeps continually growing and growing and growing bigger and bigger, okay? So now, in the future, if John wants to send that same dollar that he received from me, right? And let's say that he wants to send it to, I don't know, let's just make up a name. I'm just gonna say Obama just for the hell of it, since everybody knows who he is, okay? He's probably not gonna like to receive a Bitcoin because he wants this system in place, okay? But anyway, I don't know. I'm not Obama, so I can't say it. I've never met the guy. I don't know. Okay, a lot of people say things about the president and things like that, but they've never met him in person. They don't know. They don't hang around with him. So I'm not going to say anything about him because I really don't know. Okay, I haven't researched his biography or anything like that. All right, and so I don't want to just throw things out there that I don't know about. Okay, it's hard enough to try to figure out the things I barely know, much less try to talk about somebody I don't know. But I'm going to use his name here anyway, okay? Because everybody knows who he is, just for the hell of it, okay? So let's just say that if John wants to send that one Bitcoin to Obama, what happens is, before he can send it, the system has to go back into it and check to see if, hey, where in past history did it show that John that even has a dollar? So they go back and then they'll find this block right here, this in the blockchain, the system will scan all of it, boom, right here, it'll show that John has it, okay? So what happens is it approves that John does have a dollar to send. So what happens is in this new blockchain right here, it will show that there's a minus one for John and then there's a plus one for Obama. And that's how the public ledger works. So at any given time, you can go back through history and check to see all the transactions. Now, okay, so that eliminates the problem here of the double spending, okay? And that was a huge problem. And this process of making the ledger public so that everybody can see how much money each account has, okay, is a huge invention.